Welcome to Coffee Time with John and Cliff.
Say good morning.
Good morning.
Good to have everybody. Sing with us our theme song.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. So glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross. My debt to pay from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high.
Did you have a good week, John?
Not too bad, George.
Oh, not bad. I know.
Double.
It's getting better. It's flat, but I'm still taking care of it.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross. My debt to pay from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way. From the earth to the cross, my debt to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name.
We lift it.
Oh,
we lift it on high.
All right, well, we got the point. Good song. Glad to have you all with us. We're still working here through the weeks to figure out our internet connection. So I know on the screen we shake a little bit, but I hope you can hear us. John's just shaking because he's dancing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, why don't you open us up in prayer today? And let's continue to pray for Brad, who's doing better with his leg.
Lord, I thank you that we can all be here today, Lord, and be able to see us, and hopefully the internet is going well. Lord, be with Brad. With his blood clot, that it heals properly, Lord. And be with everybody that is watching and those who aren't. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. It's going to be a warm one.
A warm one.
A warm, warm, warm one. So make sure you're safe and you're hydrated because it's going to be a warm one. We'll sing another song and then we're going to do our scripture and devotion. You know what? John, we didn't practice this, but we never do together.
Oh.
But this song here is kind of a cute little song. I hope that you do this today. I once was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in, and then a little light from heaven filled my soul. It bathed my heart in love and wrote my name above, and just a little walk with Jesus made me whole. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our troubles. He will hear our famous cry, and he'll answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will burn it, and you know a little fire is burning, find a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
I hope you do that.
Sometimes my past seems drear, without a ray of cheer. And then a cloud of doubt may hide the light of day. The midst of sin may rise, and
just a little talk with Jesus clears the way. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about us. There's a friend who watches day and night. I go to him in prayer. He knows my every care. And just a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our troubles. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will burn him, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell him all about our troubles. He will hear our faintest cry, and he will answer by and by. Now when you feel a little prayer will turn it, and you know a little fire is burning, you will find a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
Wow, here we go again. Anyway, we just want you to have a talk with Jesus today. You keep your heart and life up to date with him. Well, John, why don't you read our devotion for us today?
All right. Okay. All you men who like music, step forward 2 paces. The sergeant said. 6 men respond. Okay. The sergeant continued. You 6, get busy and carry that piano up to the top floor of the office quarters. No doubt these 6 men were surprised as their sergeant commanded. Yet, as disciplined soldiers, they wouldn't even think of making excuses or argue with the sergeant. They would simply do the work that the sergeant had commanded them to do. Should it be any different for us with Christ Jesus? It was professed to followers of Christ. We are to do the work he has called us to do, enthusiastically and without question. What is that work? Jesus instructs his disciples, go there forward and make disciples of all nations, teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. In other words, you are to share the love of Christ with everyone you meet. We are to be imitators of Christ, pattern our lives with an example in helping others come to know him. Our Lord helps me to be your faithful disciple, today and every day.
That's a good devotion. How would you like to carry a piano up today? Not on a day like this.
I probably couldn't do it anyway.
Hey, show them the gum. This might be the last week we do gum. I am going to mix things up, and we're going to find a different prize. So your last chance to win this delicious pre-chewed gum.
Yes.
From John.
And we'll lose bubbles maybe next week.
No. Maybe bubbles. Yeah. Tiny bubbles. But our 2 questions today you can respond to, okay? And we'll give away 2 packs of gum for the winner of each. All right? Name someone you have been mistaken for. You've been mistaken for Tom Selleck?
No.
And name a contest you have won. Is there any contest you have won?
Sports or anything? Never won a contest. I won a bowling championship.
Well, that's a contest. Tell me about it.
Doubles? My average at the time was like 165, and the guy I bowled with had an average of over 200, but we both bowled 50 pins above our average for the tournament.
You got a nice trophy.
Oh, and money.
Yeah, of course. I won 2nd place when I was in high school. It was what they called the Nazarene Church had Celebrate Life. Mm-hmm. And I won a ping pong tournament contest. Got 2nd place. There's only 2 of us, by the way.
Only 2 of us.
They couldn't get anybody to enter.
Nobody wanted to play.
No. So, who's ever watching today, if you...
We're really jittery, aren't
you? Yeah, that's just the internet connection. I'm working on it and trying different things every week till we get it right. Sometimes I go right through the computer and then it's all fadey. So, we're going through the phone. We're going to try something different next week. So, we'll figure it out.
There's got to be a way to figure that out.
I
have no clue.
Yeah. But we're just glad you can hear us. Here on Coffee Time from the Spooner Church of the Nazarene. Well, let's do another song, John. Are you ready?
Sure.
All right, here's a good one in Loretta Lynn style. I like Loretta Lynn.
Oh, wow. Stand by Your Man.
Well, no, that's Tammy Wynette. You got the wrong one there. It's Tammy Wynette. All right, you stand by your woman.
Verizon knows how to build.
Here we go. I thought I got rid of those.
America's most awarded network. Offered
nine,
built for everyone.
Eight,
with the phone
seven.
Everyone loves,
we're
the
not,
watch everyone wants.
Not
buy iPhone 11, get one on us. Plus, $150 off Apple Watch.
Oh, man.
This
John
is unlimited belt
for
right.
Christmas. Here we go. I hope you... excuse me. I donut going through. Sickness with us if you're going.
Will the circle be unbroken? By and by, Lord, by and by. There's a banner over waiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. I was standing by my window on a cold and cloudy day when I saw first come rolling, for to carry my mother away. Will the circle be unbroken? By and by, Lord, by and by. There's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Now this is just the break. I'm just saying, you got this line. No, it's a poor flower.
Undertaker, please drive slow. For the body you are carrying, Lord, I hate to be alone. Will the circle be unbroken? I am my Lord. In the sky.
That's an old country song. We're going to do one like that similarly in a little bit. Before John reads a scripture for today, name someone you have been mistaken for and name a contest you have won. Be creative. Tell us something
about
it. My
older brother.
What about, you've been mistaken for your old?
Yeah, we looked a lot alike.
I've never been mistaken for my sister, though.
Yeah. Well, I hope. Well, you were wearing your dresses, weren't you?
Oh, now, there's some people, my dad will always, my brother's name is Jim Cliff. So he says, you know, Clifford called me the other day. You mean Jim? Yeah.
Because I'm calling you now.
Well, my sister Carrie, her son Jason, for years she would call him Clifford because she said, he reminds me so much of you. So,
but then you, yeah.
Why don't you read? We're going to read the first chapter of 1 John into the right down to here.
First chapter.
All the way to chapter 2 from verse 7. Yeah, go ahead.
Verse 7?
Verse 1, starting at chapter.
Okay.
Oh, I did that wrong. I'm sorry.
Woo, chapter 1.
Yeah,
ooh,
go
good
ahead.
Thing,
here we go.
Through how far? To 7?
Chapter 2, verse 7.
To 7.
It's real short.
Okay, the former account.
Give you the wrong book.
Oh, gee.
That's my fault. Here we go. This one. Through
7?
Yeah, why don't you just read it right to here.
Where
all
is it?
This right to here.
5 to
3. Yeah, those two columns. All right.
Okay, now this is the message which we have heard from him and declare to you that God is light and in him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in the dark, we lie and do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light and he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say that we have no sin, we declare ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just for us and to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all our unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. My little children, these things I write to you so that you may not sin. And if anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, and righteous. And he himself is the portion for a proportion for our sin, and not for ours only, but also the whole world's. By this we know that we know him if we keep his commandments. He who says, I know him, and does not keep his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. But whoever keeps his word truly and loves, and truly the love of God is perfect in him. By this we know that we are in him. He who says he is, abides him, ought himself also walk just as he walked.
You know, it's kind of funny, you talk about one time at my last church, there was I gave a guy a scripture in the church, and I gave him the wrong one, and it had all those hard words. And he went home and studied them and did them real well, and I didn't have the heart to tell him I gave him the wrong scripture. You know those names that are hard to pronounce?
Yeah, propitiation.
Yeah. Can you read what Dave said there?
I can.
Okay.
Oh, where is it?
Okay, I got to get
to Dave Cash.
Yeah.
I won a couple speech contests when I was in grade school.
Then he said?
And he said, when I was a younger teenager, I used to answer the phone, and the person on the other end would say, Miss Cash, I hated that.
Oh, I hated that. Oh, that is funny. Oh, well, Dave, you do not sound like you have a womanly voice, by the way. Very manly. Very manly. That's our two questions today. Name someone you've been mistaken for and a contest you won. Anybody else you've been mistaken for? You've been thinking. You know, I tell people, just joking around, and say, you know, people get me mixed up for my twin brother, Tom Selleck, and most kids are like, who's that?
Yeah.
So I don't know. Brad Pitt, he's kind of old, too. I don't know who the popular hunk is today.
Some younger guy.
Some younger guy that I don't follow. Well, we are going to do another song here, if I can get this to work. We did that one. Okay, not that one. This is similar to the last one. No, not that one. This is similar to the last one we sang, John, okay? Has some of the same lyrics.
Some of? Oh, it's Johnny Cash.
Jetty Sang Big. Sing it with us on Coffee Time. I remember when I was a lad, times were hard and things were bad. But there's a silver lining behind every cloud. Just four people, that's all we were, trying to make a living out of black and dirt. But we get together in the family circle, singing loud.
Daddy sang bass.
Mama sang tenor.
Me and little brother, we joined right in there. Singing songs to help a troubled soul. One of these days, it won't be long, I'll rejoin them in a song. I'm gonna join the family circle at the roll. No, the circle won't be broken. By and by, oh, by and by.
Daddy sang bass.
Mama sang tenor.
Me and little brother, we joined right in there. In the sky, Lord, in the sky.
You look like you're harder there, buddy.
I remember after work, Mama would call in all of us. You could hear us singing for a country mile. My little brother has done gone on, but I'll rejoin him in a song. We'll be together again up yonder in a little while.
Daddy sang bass.
Mama sang
tenor. Me and little brother join right in there. That singing seems to help a troubled soul. One of these days, and it won't be long, I'll rejoin him in a song. I'm gonna join the family circle at the throne. Oh no, the circle won't be broken. By and by, Lord, by and by.
Daddy sang bass.
Mama sang tenor.
Me and little brother, we joined right in there. In the sky, Lord, in the sky. In the sky, Lord, in the sky.
That's an oldie. I think that, of course, I don't know how they do it. They take those songs. Mm-hmm. And they take the voice of Johnny Cash out. You could hear Drew Carter.
Yep.
At the Statler Brothers. But he is one guy I wish I could have went to see in concert, Johnny Cash. Mm-hmm. You know, maybe in heaven. So name someone you've been mistaken for and name a contest you have won. Might be the last week you get gum because we're going to start something new. Brad said, after I started buzz cutting my hair, people I worked with said I looked like Uncle Fester
from the Munsters.
No, I think Uncle Fester was the Adams Family.
Yeah. Adams Family. Yep.
Well,
wrong.
No. Wrong. Well, Brad, you did look like Uncle Fester, but yes. He wasn't from the Munsters, okay? Hey, that's funny. Hey, I was once in a while we're gonna do some funny sayings, and John's gonna respond to them. What do you think about ability? What do you think of when you think of ability?
Something you can do.
That's pretty obvious. How many people, John, does it take to screw in a light bulb in the basement of the White House?
Oh boy. How many Secret Service men does it take?
No, yeah. How many? It says answer none.
None.
They prefer to do it in the dark.
Oh boy.
How many Harvard MBAs? What's an MBA? I forgot. It's something like a high degree.
Masters of something.
Masters, okay. How many Harvard MBAs does it take to screw in a light bulb?
Oh gosh. 10.
Only one.
Only one.
He stands still and holds on to the bulb, and the world revolves around him.
Masters of Bachelor's Art? No, I don't know.
Yeah, that one wasn't real that funny, but anyway.
I'm gonna think about that.
We're going to, John and I are going to have to come up with new prizes, because we've done the gun first, so the gun.
The gun. We shot the gun.
And, hey, we're glad you're joining us for coffee time. And that Uncle Fester one is pretty good, and so is Pastor Dave's. But we have to come up with something for next week. Hey, I also want to tell you, if you go to YouTube and type in Prairie Files, Shannon Rogers, Brad's niece, has got a great ministry uploaded there. Just did some interviews with Brad, and they're just tremendous. And she is very gifted, and I just wanted to give a plug for that. Well, you know what? It's time for our fun song of the day.
Master's in Degree in Business.
Oh, Master's of Degree in Business. Okay. This song here you don't usually sing in church. It's a Merle Haggard song, but it has a good message about two people that had a disability and God brought them together. I think it's a great song. You remember this one?
Mr. Merle Haggard?
Do you remember this Daddy Frank song? It's a good song.
Know.
Well, hopefully we can sing.
Guitar man. Daddy Frank's played the guitar and the French harp. Sister played the ringing tambourine. Mama couldn't hear our pretty music. She read our lips and held the family safe. That little band was all part of living. And our only means of living at the time. And it wasn't like no normal family combo. Just Daddy Frank, the guitar man, was blind. Frank and Mama counted on each other. Their one and only weakness made them strong. Mama did the driving for the family, and Frank made a living with a song. One home was just a camp along the highway. A pickup bed and there we bedded down. Don't ever once remember going hungry, but I remember Mama cooking on the ground. Daddy Frank played the guitar and the French harp. Sister played the ringing tambourine. And Mama couldn't hear the pretty music. She read our lips and held the family sing. That little land was all a part of living, and our only means of living at the time. And it wasn't like no normal family combo, just Daddy Frank, the guitar man, was blind. Don't remember how they got acquainted. I can't recall just how it came to be. Had to be some special help from someone, and blessed be the one who let it be. Fever caused my mama's loss of hearing. Daddy Frank was born without a sight, and Mama needed someone she could lean on, and I believe the guitar man was right. Daddy Frank played the guitar and the French harp. Sister played the ringing tambourine. Mama couldn't hear our pretty music. She helped our roots and helped the family sing. That little band was all a part of living, and our only means of living at the time. And it wasn't
you remember that song?
Nope.
You don't remember it? Well, it's an old, I like it because it's just kind of a neat song, well written. Hey, Dan, Donald Hurst is watching. And I'm watching and...
I'm watching a Western program this morning.
Okay. That's us.
Yeah, yeah.
Because of the music. Johnny Cash.
Oh, sure.
And The Circle Be Unbroken, Merle Haggard.
Yeah.
Hey, I like that.
Go roping some steers.
Hey, we got a couple answers in. Name someone you've been mistaken for. And name a contest you have won. I think we're down as far as we can go on
so
that.
So far.
Yeah. What do you think of, John, when you think of the word acceptance?
Acceptance.
Boy, I'm really getting deep
wow,
this morning.
Wow, somebody really, or somebody has confidence in you. They
okay.
They accept you.
I ain't saying there's a right or wrong answer. I'm just trying to make you look smart.
Or stupid.
No! Infatuation or love? Infatuation is thinking... He's as good-looking as Robert Redford, as smart as Henry Kissinger,
wow.
as noble as Ralph Nader, as funny as Woody Allen, and as athletic as Jimmy Connors. This is an
Jimmy
old
Jimmy Connors, that is old, I guess. Yeah.
But loving is realizing he's as good-looking as Woody Allen, as smart as Jimmy Collins, or Jimmy Connors, as funny as Ralph Nader, as athletic as Henry Kissinger, and nothing like Robert Redford, but you'll take him anyway. Oh, you remember, I always hear these women say, I had the perfect man in line, and then he came along. So that's
oh,
just
God,
how it is.
That's me.
No, you know. Another one on acceptance. Maxine Dunham tells the story of an elderly man who began spending a significant amount of time with an elderly woman. Neither had ever been married, and each had lived alone for many years. Gradually, the old gentleman recognized a real attachment for her.
Mm-hmm.
But was shy, kind of like you.
Oh, yeah.
And to reveal his feelings for her. After many days of anxiety and fear, he finally, get this, I love this story. He finally mustered up
the courage
to declare his intentions. He went over to her home.
Mm-hmm.
In a nervous frenzy, blurted out, "Let's get married." Surprised. She threw up her hands and shouted, "It's a wonderful idea, but who in the world will have us?"
Oops. Oh boy.
When I met Penny back in 96, I thought, you know, I'm just going to go after her till she tells me to get lost. Now, you and Tammy weren't right away. You kind of, you worked together, didn't you?
Yeah, for about a year
okay.
before. I actually met her at her birthday party.
Mm-hmm.
Her sister invited me. And then we didn't see each other for about 6 months. And then she came down to live with her sister and worked there for a year before I finally had the courage to ask her home.
So
then
did.
I asked her to marry her 6 months later. In 1989, we got married.
Did you get on your knee?
No.
Well, Penny said, why don't you get on your knee?
That.
I said, well, I already know you're going to say yes. Why do I have to go through the formality?
Here.
You know, why do I have to go? Hey, our two questions today, we got a couple good answers in. Name someone you've been mistaken for. And name a contest you have won. John and I are going to think of some good ideas for different prizes down the road here. Marcia said, I won a snowmobile trip from church about 42 years ago. Do you still have pictures from that, Marcia? That would be fun to see. Okay. Snowmobile. You know what? For a lot of years there, man, about 15, 20 years ago, we hardly had any snow around here to do any snowmobiling. Mm-hmm. And so, well, cool. Marcia won a snowmobile trip. What's one thing that happened on that, Marcia, that's worth telling? You can say that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's sing another song here today, and we're going to do some more funny talk and get more of John's smartness when I bring up stuff, all right? All right, hopefully you don't get a commercial. I hope this is your testimony on Coffee Time. We're still working on our internet connection in the weeks to come, but thanks for bearing with us. Shady green pastures, so rich and so sweet. God leads dear children along, where the waters cool flow, makes the weary ones feet. God leads dear children along. Some through the waters, some through the flood, some through the fire, but all through the blood. Some through great sorrow, but God gives a song in the night season and dawn.
shines in the valley and darkest of night. God leads dear children on. Some through the water, some through the flood, some through the fire, but all through the blood. Some through great sorrow, but God gives a song. In the night season and all the day long. Oh, sorrow befall us and Satan upholds. God leads his dear children along. Though grace we can conquer, defeat all our foes. God leads his dear children along. Some through the water, some through the blood, some through the fire, but all through the blood. Some through great sorrow, but God gives a song in the night season and all the day long. Away from the mire and away from the clay, God leads his dear children along. Away up in glory, eternity's day, God leads his dear children along. Some through the water, some through the flood, some through the fire, but all through the blood. Some great sorrow, but God gives a song in the night season and all the day long.
Well, you know, I think about that song a lot. I don't know how some people make it through life without Jesus. What a great song. He's a constant friend. I know, John, as you think about your life, imagine where you'd be without Jesus. You don't want to.
Maybe dead.
Maybe dead. Yes. You know, I like what Don Hurst often says. I thank the Lord from what he's kept me from.
Mm-hmm.
God is such a gracious God. Hey, Dave comes up about 9 o'clock with Sunday school. Worship at 10:45 with John and I and the praise team. And tonight, I'm going to be at the Hurst with Brad and maybe Harriet. We're going to be over there doing a monthly Bible study. It'll be on our Sunday night praise program, and it'll be live here on Facebook. Name someone you've been mistaken for. That's our first pack of gum. And name a contest you have won. I won. Let me share this with you. A guy called me up. I won a trip to Orlando.
Oh,
on a timeshare. But
I
had to go listen to this spiel about a timeshare. And when he was done, I said, not interested. Oh, he was mad.
Sure.
Said, there's no pressure to buy. No pressure to buy.
Okay.
But at the end, he was mad.
I'm sure he was.
He was downright mad.
It was a trip to the timeshare.
Finally, I told him, I said, I don't want the trip. I'd have to pay for a penny to go anyway. I'm too cheap. So not because I didn't want her to go, just that it was a lot of money at the time, Well, John, what do you think about, be careful with this answer, about accidents?
What type of accidents?
Any kind of accident. Well, one person.
Car accident?
Yeah. Some believe the shin was invented for finding furniture in the dark.
Oh, yeah.
Others find the little toe much more effective for such activities. Accomplishments. We've been talking about name something you have won, and it could have been an accomplishment. A young man named Jack, I can't even pronounce his last name, had purchased archery equipment and could hardly wait to try it out. Knowing the bales of hay would provide an excellent backdrop for a target, but having none readily available, he chose to use more obtainable facilities.
Oh boy.
Several sheets of insulated board leaning against an old outbuilding seemed to provide the perfect substitute.
I can already see what's happening.
After centering the target over the boards, he stepped off the required distance to practice shooting. He strung the bow, carefully fitted an arrow onto the bowstring, drew the arrow, and fired. Although the arrow struck the target, the instantaneous sound of breaking glass was the first indication that the target area might not have been a good choice. In the springtime, however, it had seemed the best place to stack all 20 of the storm windows from the house. The arrow had passed through the target, the insulation boards, and the entire stack of glass windows, breaking every one. Oh, he had to be just bummed. There are times that the results of our best aimed intentions are not what we planned them to be, but when we least expect. Proper planning involves looking beyond the obvious and checking for the possibilities of broken glass.
My stupid one was, with a bow, was aiming it straight up and seeing where the bow, where the arrow would land. But there turned out to be enough wind where it nearly hit the neighbor.
Oh my goodness.
That would have been bad.
Well,
I got deep trouble for that.
Yeah, you know what? About a month ago, I told you about it that you may have heard it, a big bang. Somebody, I think, was lighting off something in Spooner, and bang!
Right.
Yeah, I don't know what it was. Oh, we got one from Marcia here. Let's see what
she has.
That's
a long one.
I'm glad.
It's,
all right.
The trip was from
Ruben and Pat Bush.
We brought the most new people into the church. Ruben used to sell Skidoo snowmobiles. He furnished the machine and the room. It was fun, but I was the new mother. Manny was only a few weeks old. Yes, old
stubborn me.
Stubborn me went on the trip anyway. I thought I was going to die. Oops.
Oh, it's funny now to laugh about it, but. Oh, it's funny. We got some good answers today. We really do. Name someone you've been mistaken for. Name a contest you have won. I've had people, I haven't been mistaken, they'll say over the years, depending if I have the beard or not, you look like Bill Parcells, remember the football coach?
Yeah.
Or Drew Carey, the one on the Price is Right.
Oh, that's mean though.
Rodney Dangerfield. I get no respect. No respect at all. Wife signed me up for a bridge party.
You didn't have bug eyes, did you? Like, did you?
Wife signed me up for a bridge, but just ruined my joke. Wife signed me up for a bridge party. Tomorrow I jump off the bridge. let's see. There's another pastor who used to be on the district. I don't know if I should share this, but we had a DS years ago, wonderful man.
Who was it?
I'm not going to say. He thought I was this individual. And he had said to him, he had talked to this fellow, I believe, about doing a revival at his church. So he thought I was him, called me up and says, by the way, I could do revival on such and such a date, and I didn't have the heart to tell him no, so I had him for revival. He did an excellent job. So, you know, if they do look like us, John, who do people say you look like?
Just like my brother. But between the three of us, at certain times in our lives, we look the same. All three of us. Probably because my mom, I don't know, genetics or something, but... other than that, no, I've never been mistaken for anybody else.
It's weird. You don't always see it. Like one of my sisters, I think I look more like my mom. And my sister Connie looks like my dad. But one time I was somewhere and a guy came up to me and says, you must be Connie's brother. You look just like him. I don't see it. So people see what they want.
Facial features maybe or something.
Yeah. So anyway, well, let's do another song here. Hey, keep writing these answers.
A song?
Name someone you've been mistaken for and name a contest you have won. All right. I don't know how well this one's going to go, John, but we're going to give it a try.
Give it a win.
All right. I'm going to have to enlarge this. This is an old... Don says we're kind of doing country this morning, so we'll see how it goes.
We're doing country. Country and western.
Get your wife back, your dog back, and your kids back if
when
you play
you
it back.
Backwards, yeah.
If this will come in. This is the old Furlin Husky song. I don't know if it's going to come on now.
Furlin Husky?
For Wings of a Snow White Dove. I don't know if it's going to come on.
We're having an issue with the
internet.
Here we go.
Oh. Gotta follow me, God. Can you read it? The wings of a snow white dove, each scent is pure, sweet love, a sign from above. The wings of a double hit. When troubles surround us, when evils come, the body grows weak, the spirit grows numb. We send out
hell. He doesn't forget us. He sends down his love on the wings of a dove.
We're getting better.
On the wings of a snow white dove. He sends his pure sweet love. A sign from above, on the wings of a dove. When Noah had drifted on the fourth rainy day, he searched for land in various ways. Troubles he had, but wasn't forgotten. He sent his love on the wings of a dove. On the wings of a snow-white dove. He sent his poor sweet love, a sign from above, on the wings of a dove. The river that day, he was baptized in the usual way, and when it was done, God bless his son, he sent him his love on the wings of a dove.
All the things with that.
On the wings of a snow-white dove, he sent his pure sweet love, a sign from above, on the wings of a dove. A sign from above, on the wings of a dove.
Anyway, it's a good song. We're not professional, we're just awful.
Yeah.
Hey, Pat's watching us. Awesome.
We're awful professional.
All right. Oh, I think Pat Pilkington, my friend from Cuba, Illinois, won a mother and daughter look-alike contest. I don't know if that was with your... I think that'd be her daughter, Amanda. They look so much alike. It is awesome. Marcia said, I won a transistor radio in grade school for selling the most books. Do you still have it, Marcia? It might be worth money. That's our two questions. Name someone you've been... mistaken for it and name a contest you've won.
I made my own radio.
Did you make your own radio? I love that. How'd you
from
do it?
From Radio Shack. They had the kits, remember?
Did you remember that commercial a few years ago about Radio Shack? And they said the 80s called and want their stuff back. But
yep.
Cumberland still has one they sell, and so does Siren still have one.
Had one here until about 10 years ago.
Yeah. I don't know. This technology is changing so, so very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's hard to... it's hard to keep up. We're glad you're tuned in to John and Cliff on Coffee Time.
That's backwards.
And
it to us,
it might be backwards the way it comes.
Oh, no.
I think it is back. If the sign is backwards, it's because I have the phone backwards today.
I was looking. I was like, what?
So you may be reading Coffee Time with Spooner Nazarene Church backwards, but it's because I had the phone that we're recording off and set backwards. Sorry about that. Anyway. We're backwards. Call us backwards. Well, I was telling you about my bursitis. It got really thick, but now it's getting... I still have some in there. It's getting better.
Was it an infection in the...
Yeah, it was like this big. It wasn't... it didn't hurt. Sometimes it did, and I just told people it was my stress ball.
Oh, my gosh.
But went to the doctor, had some shots and some medicine. It's getting better. I was off work a few days because the doctor didn't want me to overdo it.
Overdo it?
It looked like Popeye. Oh, anyway, if you read this sign, it's backwards probably on your computer today because I didn't realize I set the phone up backwards. But anyway, so just keep writing in. Hey, and we're working on our internet connection and all that too in the weeks to come. We just are having fun today. What do you think of accountants, John?
Oh, I don't know. I don't like them much. I don't know.
We don't, because they always have more money.
They want
some good accountants. When you make the mistake of adding the date to the right side of the accounting statement, you must add it to the left side, too.
Oh, darn.
Yeah. Here's one about action. Preacher to the congregation. Crying babies and disruptive children like good intentions should be carried out immediately. We don't I don't believe that. All right. Can you tell us the... I still remember, because Pastor Frazier told the story about your boy. When you were being Missy Haven, and what did he say? I love this story. Now they were taking him out of the sanctuary, right?
In her arm, under his arm. He's going to kill me. She's going to kill me.
All the kids have a way of doing that.
Help me, help me.
Well, here's one about activity. You're an active guy. This age, this is the age of the half-read page and the quick hash and the mad dash. Ooh. The bright night with the nervous tight. Whatever that means. The plain hop and the brief stop. The lamb tan and the short pan span. A big shot in a soft spot. And the brain strain in the heart pain. And the cat naps till spring snaps. And the fun is done. We do live in kind of a fast-paced world, don't we?
Very.
We do. Hey, you can also text in. It's not part of the contest. Maybe you want to text in a testimony today. I don't always say that enough. If you want to type in a testimony as well. Well, let's do one more here. About advice. Okay, are you ready?
Oh, yeah.
A grandmother who was concerned about her granddaughter's vocabulary frequently advised the children concerning her chosen words. Did your mom ever have words that she didn't like you to say? My mom didn't like the word ain't.
Taint?
Ain't.
Ain't. Ain't.
Was yours naughty words?
Probably.
Okay. Well, on one occasion, grandma said, "Dear child, I would like you to do something for me. Would you please promise not to use two words. One is swell and the other is lousy." And the granddaughter responded this way. "Sure, Grandma, what are the two words?"
Oh.
Wing! Right over the top of the head. Oh, did your mom...
Must be a blonde.
Was there any... Yeah. You know how... This I hope I don't get in trouble, but you know how you could use it for any ethnic. But how... Why they put the demonstrators on the floor so blondes don't get their feet caught in the steering wheel. And how do you know that a blonde used a computer? You've heard that whiteout on the screen.
Yes.
Was there anything your mom used to get after you about? Bad habits? Or your dad?
Oh, boy. I have to think about that one for a second. How about you?
Oh, yeah. Turn it back on me. Oh, there's all kinds of them. Let's do one more and we'll do another song. Advertising. A local farmer had come to the conclusion that the local car dealer had profited greatly by all the add-on options that increased the price of cars sold to the hapless farmer. Then one day, the car dealer informed the farmer that he was coming around to buy a cow. In spite of justice, the farmer attached the following price information to the cow. Basic cow, $500. Two-tone exterior, $45. Extra stomach, $75. Product storing compartments, $60. Straw chopper, $120. Four spigots at $10 each. Okay. $40 for cowhide upholstery, $125 for dual horns.
Dual horns.
And I think another one was $38 for automatic fly swatter. And fertilizer attachment for
$185. Ouch.
Oh, I remember getting
for a total of.
Total of $1,233. This must be the Price is Right.
Yes.
Why don't you read number 13 for us, John? Read number 13.
13. Overly helpful. Three men were about to be executed by the guillotine. One was a Frenchman, one was an Englishman, and the other was an American. The Frenchman went first. He was asked if he wanted to wear a hood over his head. He declined and said he was not afraid. He was placed under the guillotine with his neck on the block. He looked up bravely at the sharp blade that was about to fall. The rope was pulled. Nothing happened. His executioner believed this was an act of God, and they freed him. The same process was repeated with the Englishman. He refused the hood, was set into place, and the rope was pulled again. Nothing happened. This too was an act of God, so they freed the Englishman as well. Now it was time for the American execution. Do you want the hood? He refused. Nope. I'm just as brave as those two other guys. They laid the American face up on the guillotine and were about to pull the rope when the American stopped them. "Hey, wait just a minute. I think I found the problem with the guillotine."
Good old American.
They left the pin in.
They left the pin in. Hey, we're going to do another song if it works here. And then we're going to come back and have a time of prayer. This has been fun today. I've enjoyed having you back, John. We haven't seen you for a couple weeks. We're glad you're here.
Yeah.
This is a famous cathedral song.
A boy in days of childhood, I used to pray till evening shadows come. Then winding down an old familiar path, I heard my mother call and said, come home, it's summertime. The shadows lengthen fast.
Now I see her standing yonder, and her familiar voice I hear once more. The banquet's table ready up in heaven. It's supper time upon that golden shore. What a great song. We're coming to the close. We've had a good time today, haven't we, John? This has been fun, and John's going to pray for us in a minute. If this is backwards today, it's because I had the camera turned around backwards, if this saying is backwards. But it is coffee time. Let us know how you like the program. We're still working on getting our internet connection just right. I just sure appreciate you all tuning in. Pastor Dave comes up at 9, worship at 10:45. We have an online program I believe scheduled from the Hearst's home tonight. That's a big word. Hearst home.
Hearst's
at,
home.
At 6:30 for our Sunday Night Praise program. We're going to have a great time. You know, I don't know where you stand on this issue with coronavirus, but the cases are spiking across the country. And we do need to be careful and wise, but not be in paranoia or anything like that. And just be, as we've been saying here at the church, we want to be wise, we want to be prudent, and we want to stay close to Jesus.
And stay safe.
And stay safe. And we are doing our very best at the church to just make it a comfortable in-person atmosphere at 10:45. And you can be safe. And if you want to wear a mask, that's fine. If you don't, that's fine too. We just are very open to whatever the Lord is leading. So John, just pray for us this week and anybody that might need Jesus in their heart.
Lord, be with us today as we go through service, Lord. And be with Pastor Dave as he does his devotional for Sunday school, Lord. Be with us as we go out into the world, Lord. Keep us safe. Keep everybody safe, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. Oh, who are some of the good answers? I liked Brad being Fester. I think he should win that one, huh?
Yep.
You all were such close answers. The other one, name a contest you won. Marsha won the snowmobile contest. She won anyway.
Yep.
So I think she should get that. Marsha, you are the gum. We're going to get a different prize.
You're the gum.
Right there. There's the gum. Pre-chewed by John. Well, I'll close with our theme song. We're going to get out of here for Pastor Dave. If you love the Lord.